majority of the question, but you still need to link it back to your case study. Now, depending upon your college would have given you different case studies. Now, the case study one of the case studies that we've been looking at is Apple. And so once you've explained all of that, you now need to bring Apple into the case study. And you need to talk about Apple, and you need to mention the organization structure. It's a large organization and structure. The company is turning over billions in terms of revenue. Organizational structure is a tall, big structure. It has a spoke wheel structure with Tim Cook at the center of it. And then it has functional departments around Tim Cook. And around the functional departments, they all report to Tim Cook, and they also communicate to each other. And then they have these SVPs, senior vice principals, which report to Tim Cook. Their decision-making process is not decentralized, but the decision-making process is actually quite centralized. And Apple, in terms of their management accounting systems, are all geared towards cost accounting and not really geared towards decision-making, but they're focused on their costs, and they look at their costs heavily. And if we look at the management accounting system in Apple, we can see that in 2011, their cost accounts were 7% of their total sales, whereas in 2010, their cost account was 8% of their total sales in 2010. But this is surprising. This is surprising simply because the cost accounting in 2011, they had grown and they had opened up more stores. They opened up more stores, they had employed more people, incorporated more research and development staff, more research and development technology, software and hardware. So their costing has actually decreased. Nevertheless, even though their costs have increased, their overall cost account percentage as a percentage of total sales has decreased. Why is this? Because they have actually decreased their overall costs throughout the whole business, even though they've spent more. So cost accounting for Apple is extremely, extremely important. With their cost account management systems, they focus on three things. They believe that direct accountability for each functional area, for each person, for each member in the organization of Apple. And to have direct accountability, they must have management accounting systems which monitor the response from each and every functional area and each and every functional person in Apple, which puts a lot of pressure on Apple and the employees in Apple, because they know that they're directly responsible for their actions, and their management accounting systems record everything to show what every single person is doing and if they're actually being efficient or not being efficient. They have an efficient cost management system, which is profit-centered for Apple, and they have another key thing, which is the low turnover of staff, which is key to Apple. Even though it's a tough environment to learn for Apple, it's absolutely key and crucial that they have a low turnover, so they keep their valuable members. They believe and they know that having a low turnover of staff is absolutely crucial, because they don't have to keep training people, they don't have to keep employing people, they don't have to keep teaching people what they need to do. And in terms of their learning curve, their staff stay with them, and not only do their staff stay with them, but the staff have a valuable and influential time at Apple. So, when we look at Apple and we look at the Apple system, we can see that they're how the cost management and costing systems change with Apple. We can see they are more geared towards controlling and planning. Controlling and planning of the company, which is very similar to Salomon and Mitchell in 2005, where they researched 92 Malaysian firms. And with Salomon and Mitchell 2005, again, they said that those firms were more geared towards planning and control, which is the same for Apple, where their costing and management and accounting systems and their change are more geared towards planning and control. If we dig deeper into Apple, we can see that the organizational capacity to learn is very, very strong. They have intense competition, but does that have a great influence on the management accounting costing systems? In my opinion, I think it's moderate. I don't think it's that strong. Apple have a centralized decision-making process, so I think that the centralization process has a negative effect on change on the management accounting costing systems. And a size and effect? Well, a size and effect, you know, it's a huge organization, Apple. And it's a worldwide organization in many different places, so I do believe that the management accounting costing systems are affected by the size and structure and has a positive effect on the size and structure. And that is all geared towards how and how being the management accounting costing systems being more geared and more focused towards really controlling and planning. So I hope really that has helped you to answer the question, because the question says compare how organizations, so key question, compare, we need to look at the differences, how organizations, explain what organizations are, and then explain management accounting systems, and then explain financial problems, but link it to what's actually affecting the financial ratios, because the ratios themselves are only a tool. It's what really affecting those financial ratios. And then use the analysis done by different authors from the research paper that I've given you on Google Docs to compare how the different authors or the similarities differ. And then you must state how they differ and how will be in terms of how it's affecting the management accounting costing systems in terms of either for decision making, for control, directing, or for planning. And then link it all back to your case study and do some research on your case study and say how, you know, what is the size, the structure, what type of management systems do they have, what type of costing system, what is the management accounting costing systems that they have in that organization. And then link it back and compare it to the different authors that I've given you. Okay, I hope that has helped. I'm just going to get my bag. I think I'll take a little walk into the sea. So I'm going to lift this up and let's just take a little walk into this boat. I love it out here. It's absolutely beautiful. It's a beautiful day. We're at Bognor Regis and I've got the whole beach to myself, and you're joining me today in this beautiful calm water. Oh, it's so nice. It is so nice. It's really windy as well. I have the whole beach for myself. Am I not truly lucky? Wow. What a wonderful day. Look out to the sea. Absolutely beautiful. Wow. Thank you very much for joining Mr. T today, looking at management accounts and question P5. Thank you.